I'm Elisa with Scripts and Scribes. We are at the Writers Guild Foundation TV Writer Symposium, and we are supremely lucky. We get to talk with from the Comedians on FX, which we're two episodes in now, right?
Yeah.
Hysterical. Like, I mean, with that cast.
Thank you.
And the writing.
Thank you. Billy and Josh are actual Hall of Famers, and it's pretty exciting to be able to work with those guys, for sure.
That's actually where I want to start, mm-hmm. is as a writer in that realm, when you have these two legends, these people that, in their own writer, just phenomenal talent, and they're very good at improv.
Yeah.
How does that work into the storyline overall? How much leverage do you give them to go off book?
Well, in the case of our show, I think to not give them leverage would be really dumb, because they're playing. First of all, they're really talented. You know, so it's like if you're gonna get comedy gold from Billy Crystal and Josh Gad, you take it. It makes me look better as a writer, and it makes the show better. But also, they're playing themselves. You know, I mean, like they're playing versions of themselves. Mm-hmm. So. There's a certain amount of, there's always a little bit of co-authorship of any character you write with the actor who ends up playing that character, but in this case, it's sort of even more baked into the cake that, you know, ultimately, I'm not going to tell Billy Crystal what his ninth birthday was like. You know what I mean? Like, he's going to own that, and he's going to be the author of that from a character perspective. So, you know, it's very, very collaborative, and as you say, it's there's a lot of improv, and they're just both great at it. It helps that they know their characters, you know?
So what you're saying here is basically that they're doing all the work, and you're just taking the
credit.
Yeah,
it's amazing. It's okay. A great job. It's a great job. If the checks ever come, I'm going to be really, really pleased. Yeah.
Yeah. So something I would like to ask you about, mm-hmm. when you're in the writer's room, or you're working on a half-hour comedy, what are some of the challenges that you run into? Because I think when I think of writing comedy, I think it's all fun, it's mm-hmm. all games, you know, you're in there, everybody's funny, it's having a good time. What are some of the challenges that you run into in that?
Well, you know, it's a lot of work. I mean, I think any, just writing however many episodes of a show, it's, you know, you're coming up with stories from scratch, you know what I mean? And that's just, there's a lot that goes into that, and you kind of never exactly know when you're done, because it can always be a little better, it can always be a little funnier. The story could have one more twist, or it could have one, you know, so it's like, it's a lot of work, but you're actually really right that it is a lot of fun. I mean, it really is. We do actually laugh all day. Like, we literally laugh all day, and both in the writer's room and on set with the guys. And, you know, I mean, I think this is, I think this is more true of our show than most shows, which is that when our show is working well, it's just because funny people are being funny. It's not rocket science, it's not brain surgery, it's just funny people who are doing their thing and comfortable, and there's a lot of writing, don't get me wrong, but I think that on the producing side, it's a little bit about just creating and fostering an atmosphere that's comfortable and loose and, you know, and like, let funny people be funny.
And I think in this case too, as a writer, you can almost write to those actors.
Oh, yeah.
You know their voices.
Yeah.
So it's a little bit easier to write in that voice.
Yeah, completely.
Which probably makes them more comfortable.
Well, and that's exactly right. And I think that, I've said about this show, I would rather do a joke that may be a B-plus joke on the page that the actor really believes in than do a joke that's an A-plus joke on the page that the actor doesn't believe in. Because the actor has to sell it, you know what I mean? If that guy thinks it's funny, then it's going to be funny, you know what I mean? And so there's a huge amount of back and forth. But also, as you say, I mean, like, I grew up watching Billy Crystal. I literally, when I was 14 years old, I used to do impressions of, you know, Sammy Davis Jr. and Fernando and Howard Cosell and all the stuff that he used to do. So, like, I literally grew up watching the guy. So, yeah, I think I know his voice reasonably well. And, you know, I'm not always right, but I definitely know who I'm writing to. And same with Josh. I mean, I've been a fan for a long time.
And I think that's important as a writer, to be flexible, to be able to write in, not necessarily, it's still your voice, but it's and encouraging the voice that's necessary for the overall
And then there's a voice of the show too. I mean, there's a you know, the show has a specific voice where it's sort of like something might be a joke that would make sense for that character, but it doesn't make sense for the show, mm-hmm. so you don't do it. You know, and it, you know, my job is often to kind of like be the arbiter of not the sole arbiter, but the, you know, like. Yeah. Have to navigate what does this show feel like and what does it sound like.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
You have to be the boss man.
The boss man. Well, you can see that I'm pretty bossy. You can tell.
Clearly.
Yeah, yeah. No, I'm pretty unpleasant.
Yeah, definitely what I think of. So basically, to wrap this up really quickly, mm-hmm. What are some tips or words of advice that you might be able to give some aspiring writers that are looking to break in? You know, we get the... Right. You know, be writing all of the time. Do you have anything additional that you can add to that that might be of benefit? I mean, anything you say is probably a benefit, but...
Well, that is really... That is... I'm not making a joke. That is really good advice. I mean, I probably wrote, 10 scripts before the first one that actually broke through for me. And it really does. Just the muscle of writing and the muscle... And just sort of, like, learning how to put something aside and pick it back up and make it better. I guess my other piece of advice, in addition to write, which is literally the best advice, is show it to people. You know what I mean? Like, bug people to read your stuff. Get it out there and sort of like, and listen to what the feedback is. Because you need, first of all, you actually do need to experience the stinging rejection of something you've done. It does. It hurts. It hurts every time.
But it makes you so much better.
But it makes you better. And you know, so I think... bounce stuff off people and then listen to their reaction. You know, don't bounce stuff off people with the like the expectation that they're going to say it's great, and then if they don't say that they're dead wrong, and you don't have to listen to them. Like, you know, that would be my other piece of advice. To scripts, but not to scribes so much. Scribes, right. You just need to keep scribing. Always be scribing.
Always be scribing.
Always be scribing. Yeah.
Sometimes scripting.
Yeah, sometimes scripting, but mostly scribing.
Thank you again very, very much for
your
time.
Of course. Thank you.
And we are with Scripts and Scribes.